This is Real News Media TV, coverage you can trust. Please like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Select all for daily news updates. Elderly man convicted for killing teen found with her throat slashed. An elderly man was today convicted for the gruesome killing of a teenage girl whose body was found with multiple stab wounds and her throat slashed. Winston Jarrett, a 62-year-old watchman, pleaded guilty to murder in the Trelawney Circuit Court for the slaying of Jelana White, 18, of Salem in Runaway Bay, St. Anne, on January last year. Jarrett was remanded and will be sentenced tomorrow by Chief Justice Brian Sykes, who presided over the case. The Duncan's police had reported that, about 6:45 a.m. on January 25, 2020, a passerby stumbled upon White's body and alerted them. The police, upon their arrival, found the corpse hidden in bushes with stab wounds and the throat slashed. Following investigations, Jarrett surrendered to the police on February 18 last year and was subsequently charged. Holness prepared to declare state of emergency in central Kingston. Prime Minister Andrew Holness says, if advised, he is prepared to declare a state of public emergency in central Kingston. Holness was reacting to news that several houses on Beeston Street were set on fire by heavily armed gunmen on Tuesday before dawn, displacing more than 30 people. As they fired wildly at the occupants, some of whom were children, one man was shot in the shoulder. He remains hospitalized. This must not happen in Jamaica. No criminal must feel that they have the power that they can go and burn down people's houses. It must never happen, and I have said to the police commissioner, no stone must be left unturned to find those who have done it. It hurt me to my heart, Holness said this morning while addressing the opening of the Olympic Gardens police station in St. Andrew. Calls have been made in recent weeks by the People's National Party caretaker for the constituency, Imani Duncan Price, protesters and victims of crime for the declaration of zone of special operations in the area. The division has experienced a surge of more than 30% in shootings and killings in 2021. Recalling the events of the Eventide home fire in 1980, which claimed the lives of more than 150 elderly women who were sleeping when the fire broke out, Holness reasoned that the trend of criminal activity in central Kingston could move in that direction. Commissioner and Chief of Defense Staff, this is something that we need to look at closely, because there must never be a time when criminals feel that they are above the law. They must shake when they see us, he remarked. Alleged Screamers gang leader convicted of gun charges. Robert Graham, the alleged leader of the Screamers gang, was convicted of gun-related charges when he appeared in the Home Circuit Court on Tuesday. Graham was found guilty of shooting with intent and illegal possession of a firearm. He will be sentenced on July 29. Graham was arrested and charged in connection with an incident in Arnett Gardens on April 20 last year. No accountability. Woman upset with hospital's response following her baby's death. Shanique Armstrong, whose baby died at the Spanish Town Hospital in St. Catherine earlier this month, has dismissed the operational changes announced for the institution, saying no one has accepted liability for her baby's death. Ms. Armstrong said she gave birth in the waiting area of the accident and emergency department with no help from staff. The board of the Southeast Regional Health Authority issued a statement on Tuesday indicating that, based on the reports received concerning the June 2 incident, a number of recommendations will be implemented immediately. Among other changes, midwives will now provide direct patient care to pregnant women, while the practice of using bedpans for miscarriage will be discontinued. Grief counseling will also be provided to women who miscarry. But speaking with the news on Wednesday, Ms. Armstrong said the statement did not go far enough, as it did not indicate who was held accountable for what happened. She said she is still traumatized by the incident, and she plans to proceed with legal action against the hospital, since this kind of situation needs to stop. It happened to me twice, and it's not just me. It keep on happen too often, and nothing now do about it, she lamented. Ms. Armstrong said she also wants to hear from the Health Minister, Dr. Christopher Tufton, and Prime Minister Andrew Holness on the matter. She is to meet with the public defender Arlene Harrison-Henry on Wednesday to discuss her case. A previous meeting was cancelled as she was ill. PM rejects claims COVID rules relaxed as election sweetener. Prime Minister Andrew Holness has refuted claims that COVID-19 measures have been relaxed to pave the way for local government elections. Holness says an election will not be held this year, and certainly not until he is satisfied that Jamaica is on the right trajectory for vaccination. He made the declaration as he gave remarks at the opening of the Olympic Gardens Police Station in St. Andrew this morning. Last November, the House of Representatives approved amendments to the Representation of the People Act to allow the local government elections to be deferred up to February 27, 2022. The bill was piloted by local government minister Desmond McKenzie. Local elections are held every 4 years, and the last poll was conducted on November 28, 2016. Dozens in limbo as gunmen torch homes. Heavily armed gunmen in central Kingston lit homes on Beeston Street before dawn on Tuesday and stalked the evacuees, firing wildly at men, women, and children fleeing from their homes. One man was shot in the shoulder and remains hospitalized. Many of the victims only salvaged the clothing on their backs in the fire that raged sometime after 4 a.m. that had estimated losses at $22 million. 4 units with 26 firefighters fought the blaze. ID, TRN, NIS, may have a level 2 certificate in welding. School certificate, everything burn up, one victim said. Kevin Peter puts his losses at $500,000. His brother Howard said he's worth twice as heavy. My wife is from Canada and she bring down all different types of things for me, Howard told the news. Howard said that he alerted a family with 3 children to escape with their lives. Me see the fire, and before me say me go take out anything out of my house, me coulda never do it. Me have to start run and wake up people out of their house. The 3 little children did a go burn up inside there, he said. The crisis in the Kingston Central Police Division has seen a year-on-year rise in shootings by 25%. Murders have soared to 37 up to June 29, a dozen more than for the corresponding period in 2020. Opposition spokesman on national security Peter Bunting has chided the government's handling of crime. 3 weeks ago, we were a bit lower year-to-date in murders compared to previous years and lower in most of the categories of serious crimes. We are very disappointed that in 3 weeks we have reversed that, and now we are at 5.5% ahead year-to-date, Bunting said during Tuesday's press briefing of the Crime Monitoring and Oversight Committee. Overall, murders stand at 696 compared to 666 in 2020. Chairman of CMOC, Lloyd Dissant Jr., again lamented missed targets on critical deliverables such as recruitment and fleet procurement to bolster crime-fighting efforts. We, of course, remain concerned with regard to just the total number of vehicles. There should be 3,000. We only have 1,800 in place. That's a huge gap, Distance said. The force aims to have a complement of 14,000 personnel by March 2024. It currently has more than 11,000. Jamaica receives 65,000 vaccine doses from Mexico. The 65,000 doses of AstraZeneca vaccine from the Mexican government have arrived in Jamaica. The vaccines arrived on Wednesday afternoon at Norman Manley International Airport in Kingston. Health Minister Dr. Christopher Tufton has said there will be vaccination blitz this weekend. 10 more COVID-related deaths, 44 new cases. 10 more people have died from COVID-19 in Jamaica, pushing the death toll to 1,075. 4 of the deaths were recorded in St. Catherine, 3 in Kingston, 2 in St. James, while St. Mary had 1. Another death is being investigated by the Health Ministry. The Ministry of Health also reported 44 new COVID-19 cases, which were confirmed Tuesday from 584 samples. The positivity rate is 6.5%. Jamaica's COVID-19 case count is now 50,124. 11 more people have been hospitalized with COVID-19 in Jamaica, bringing the total to 127. 10 of the cases are critical. Please remember to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Select all for daily news updates.